Thank you very much, Manuel. So we can close also the second part now and go immediately to the third one, that is about the new 5G platform features. So I kindly ask Evangelos to start sharing. In this session, we will see essentially an overview of the 5G performance diagnosis tools, an introduction with a demo, and finally a demonstration. So thanks, Evangelos, the floor is yours.
Hello, thank you very much. Okay, so good afternoon. We will, in this presentation, we will present you. I'm Evangelos Kosmatos. I'm with WINGS ICT Solutions, and I am the leader of Work Package 5 in 5G, which is about testing and validation. So in this session, we're going to present you the new 5G platform feature, and especially the performance diagnosis functionality, which is a feature that is designed, developed, and integrated into the 5G platform during the last year of the project. During the session, we are also going to present you two small demos. The first one will illustrate how a vertical can use the performance diagnosis tool in 5G. And a second one, it's about the actual application of this performance diagnosis tool in a specific use case. We will make this presentation together with my colleague Yannis. I go through a small introduction, more or less about the 5G performance diagnosis tool. What is the motivation for, let's say, designing and developing a 5G diagnosis tool as part of the 5G? In principle, the verticals require automated tools to ensure the reliability and the high performance of the services that are running on top of the 5G network. And in the same time, they are required effective methods and tools for the maximization of the and the appropriate allocation of virtual resources, which should be fine-tuned to the needs of their 5G services. Also, there's a need for automated prediction and localization of faults and service degradation, with the intention to then trigger the generation of automated decisions and improving the performance degradation or even mitigating these possible faults. In addition, we believe that this diagnostic tool can maximize the impact of the 5G vertical application testing. If we go to the next slide, you can see the overall architecture of the different components of the 5G platform. As you can see, the performance diagnosis tool is on the right hand of the architecture. You can see here with the green color, it's the components which are related with the portal. With the yellow one, you can see the components that are related with the networking layer. On the bottom, we have, of course, the infrastructure. And with the red one are the components that are related with the actual testing, validation, and also the performance diagnosis. This performance diagnosis tool targets the maximization of the impact of the testing and validation procedure by, first of all, monitoring the health status of the nodes in the service graphs and try to identify any performance degradations. It offers some insights regarding the performance of the overall performance of the experiments by applying post-processes analysis on the collected metrics and also in the generated KPIs. It also executes root cause analysis in order to identify the elements that may generate this, let's say, degradation or the impairment. And also, we As a final step of this tool, we try to compare the performance of different, let's say, candidate service deployment in order to come to a service profiling result that will be valuable for the vertical. Just to, let's say, to summarize the capabilities of the performance diagnosis tool, you can see here that it can estimate the health status of all the involved nodes using self-organizing maps. It execute root cause analysis using related algorithms based on adjacency lists. And finally, it offers some service from final insights. So in this slide, we try to go more in details in the algorithms that are staying behind, let's say, behind this tool. Regarding the estimation of the net of the health status of the node, we are using SOMS, the self-organizing map. Just to give a small intro, a self-organizing map, it's a type of artificial neural network that can be trained in an unsupervised way and apply competitive learning. In order to train the SOM, we of course use unsupervised modeling, and during the training we use metrics coming from heterogeneous sources, like metrics coming for system, for the network, and also application level metrics. There are some weights that are calculated for each neuron, and finally a model is produced which is coupled for the diagnosis. During the deployment, initially the node metrics are fed to the training SOM when the experiment is it finishes, so it collects all the metrics, and it's try to monitor the health status of each node in the graph, and it's determined the health status by comparing the neuron weights that we have this as an output of the training, and also the node collected data. Just to mention that the percentage deviation of the metrics from the model's weights is continually monitoring in order to identify if a node is healthy or not. Now, in addition to identify if a node is healthy or not, the algorithm try to find the most possible cause of a deviation and try to in order to provide more insights to the vertical. So as you can see in the right hand, after the experimentation, we see that based on the result, the most possible cause for this specific impairment is the CPU utilization and then the memory utilization. So if we go to the next slide, this is more related with the next step of the performance diagnosis, which is the root cause analysis. The input of the root cause analysis is first the health status results that are coming from the SOM algorithm. So it's the result from the first, the previous algorithm I already presented. And also this tool is take into consideration the service topology information and use this as an end node in directed graph and represented as an adjacency list. So during the actual operation, in the first step, it's determining estimate the status of individual elements in the networks using the service topology for each available network path. And for this, for the initial service topology, it tried to identify the different network path that this topology includes. And in the second step, it checks the non-reachable nodes that let's say they are blocked for others that are not already non-healthy, so in order to identify the later as root causes. So the final results depict both the detailed health status of the nodes using the SOM and also the path status of the topology using the root cause analysis. So a result is what is, let's say, illustrated in the bottom figure. Then, finally, another very important functionality, it's the service profiling. The input is the KPI generated during the experiment, and also the candidate service deployments, for example, the how the virtual resources are allocated in each, let's say, service experiment. And in the deployment, in the first step, we collect the results of the execution for each unique deployment, and we calculate in the second step the resulting performance per deployment option correlated with the service deployment characteristics. So you can see results from performance diagnosis in which we compare three deployment, let's say, options. Now, what is also important for the verticals is who can use the diagnostic, how an experimenter can use the tool, and where the results are depicted. So who can use the diagnostic tool? Diagnostic tool can be used by any vertical or experimenter who'd like to plan to use the 5G platform for service validation, even if it's a use case inside or outside the 5G project. Or any vertical experimenter, who plans to use the 5G platform for identifying any possible performance degradation or impairments and plan to apply root cause analysis. How an experimenter can use the tool? During the experiment design phase in the portal, the experimenter should first select the options to enable the performance diagnosis support. Then, during the experiment design, the vertical should, let's say, follow some defined naming conventions, which are presented in detail in the first demo I'm going to present you. And also, they are provided in more detail in 5G user manual. So all the other necessary information are collected through the 5G interworking layer. I mean the network service descriptors, the related information from the blueprints, and also the metrics from the Kafka server. Now, where the results of the diagnostics tool are represented, the diagnostic results are presented on the final validation report, which is available in the portal, together with the validation KPI validation results from the experiment. So it's in the same place with the KPI validation results of the 5G. So now I am going to demonstrate you the first demo in which we try to explain the actions that need to be taken by the verticals in order to use the diagnostics tools, and we explain the steps that need to be taken for all the process, let's say in the experiment design, in the experiment execution, then in the service deployment, and finally the results that are generated in the report. So I will start the first demo. Okay, so in order to effectively use the performance diagnosis tool, a few naming conventions should be followed in the 5G portal during the design execution and also an execution phase of the experiment. So if we start with the design phase in the vertical service blueprint, in which it's a place where we define the application metrics, the application metrics should be defined with a prefix which is equal to the respective node that this metric is generated. So the vertical should use this prefix in order, this prefix, just to explain it, let's say, is used by the performance diagnosis tool in order to correlate the metrics with the experiment topology and the nodes in order to estimate the health status and make the root cause analysis. So this is the first one, and the second one is the network service descriptor for every VNF that is used should go to the flavor ID property of the VNF profile ID, and in this should also use the same naming convention. So the name, this name, just to clarify, should be consistent across the vertical service blueprint, the network service description, and also the configuration of the approach that actually generate the metrics. So in addition, during the experiment design phase, the vertical should define the KPIs to be validated. So when is defined the KPIs, should also use this naming convention. So put in the as a prefix the name of the node that are related with this specific KPI. If the KPI is general, is not let's say belonging to a node, and belongs let's say to the whole service, then no action should be taken here. So after the experiment has been designing, the vertical can request the execution of the experiment. So in this phase, the only thing that the vertical should do is to check to enable the performance diagnosis tool. So then the service is executed. I mean, the service is deployed on the OpenStack, as you can see here. And the actual execution of experiment is taking place. You can see some screenshot for the deployment in OpenStack and finally. So after the, when the execution finished, the vertical can select to see the report that is already generated. And in this report, in addition to the KPIs, to the KPI validation results that you can see here, there's a second part which is related with the performance diagnosis, in which we demonstrate the status of the nodes, the topology, and also the results of the service profiling. So I finished with the first demo, and this is the first demo. And the second one demo, it's the actual application of diagnostics on the smart city use case. In 5G, if the smart city use case is realized by a set of AirWings board, the AirWings board are some boards which contains a set of sensors that can generate 9 different parameters for the air quality, and also the AirWings service, which is running on the server, on the application server. So in order to demonstrate diagnostic tool, we deploy our deployments emulate the smart city use case. So the actual AirWings service is deployed in one VNF using the 5G infrastructure, and then we have another VNF which emulate the functionality of the AirWings sensors and send packet to the AirWings through a set of relay nodes. The actual topology of this, let's say, deployment can be seen in the bottom. So you can see here that we have a device gateway in which we emulate the different sensors. As I said, it goes through a hub that forwards traffic to two relay nodes, and then this goes to the AirWings server. So in order to demonstrate the usage of the diagnostic tool, we apply fault injection in randomly to one of the two intermediate nodes, and you will see the results of of the performance diagnosis tool. So at this side, we are going to the second demo. So now I will give the floor to my colleague Yannis in order to present you this second demo. Thank you very much for my side.
Greetings to everyone. I am Yanis Hondroulis from WINGS. So let's start with our second video. Okay, I think you can see my screen now. The first step is the experiment instantiation for our use case. I'm sorry, but let me start my camera as well. Okay, as a presenter. Okay, so the first step is the experiment instantiation for our use case, as I said, following the typical procedures that are dictated by the 5G portal. We have already prepared the service beforehand, so we will skip the instantiation waiting time. As you can see, it's now in an instantiating state, and soon enough it will be fully instantiated. Now we will see our orchestration tool, which is OSM, how the service runs there, and the service graph produced automatically by the tool. And then we'll proceed with the virtual infrastructure manager, which is OpenStack, and we will see how our service instances are running there as well. After the service will be instantiated, we will move on to the experiment execution. And during this phase, we enable the performance diagnosis tool, as you can see, following the steps presented in the first video. So doing that will result in additional analysis of the generated metrics and KPIs and the generation of more in-depth report regarding the performance of our service. So, as we can see, the first thing available on the report are the validation results, and this information includes general information regarding the experiment, as well as statistics collected and calculated using the metrics and KPIs during the experiment execution. We can see the results of the individual test cases and that are executed and the performance of the examined KPIs for each one of them. These results become available to the vertical after the execution of the experiment has concluded, regardless of the use of the performance diagnosis tool. It is the go-to functionality to validate the performance of the tested service. So moving on to the actual performance diagnosis results, the first of which is the status analysis of the various elements of the experiment. So on the status analysis timeline, the user can have an overview of the service status for the whole duration of the experiment. And each tile indicates the health status of a node at a given moment. So as we can see, green tiles represent healthy nodes, and orange tiles represent an unhealthy state of a node that quickly becomes healthy again, and that's why the label says spike. And finally, the red tiles show that a node is continuously unhealthy for a series of timestamps, as you can also see. So to troubleshoot the non-healthy nodes, the user proceeds to the diagnostic analysis segment. We can see the service topology, and that by clicking on a node, the user can have a look at its detailed status analysis. So we will see that there are available the respective status metrics and KPI values on the right side of the screen. And as we can see, the topology is visualized at any given moment using our timestamp slider. And a similar color code visualization is implemented as well. So we'll see that the green nodes are fully healthy, and the yellow ones are healthy but tend towards a problematic state. And then the orange nodes perform poorly, and that's why they need attention, as the label says. And the red ones are in a critical non-healthy state. as we will see. So for a more detailed diagnosis of the low performing nodes, the user can observe the root cause analysis and SOM model comparison segments. And on the left side, its network path implemented at application level is shown using the timestamp slider. Again, by clicking on a node, the root cause analysis diagnosis is shown, indicating the node's health, the reachability status, as well as the probable root causes, root cause nodes. So, for example, we see that the critical non-healthy state of Relay 1 node affects the device gateway's performance on the first of the two paths, and therefore Relay 1 is reported as the root cause node of the gateway's low performance. And furthermore, on the right side, the user can have a look at the deviation of its metric value from the respective weight value of the trained model's neuron. Now that the user has successfully diagnosed the issue, because increased high application level and network level latency values cause the non-healthy state of the gateway. So this is because the Relay 1 node is in a critical underperforming state, as we can see, because of the high CPU and memory utilization values caused by the introduced, as Vangelis mentioned, fault injection. So the above issue is confirmed by the high deviation from the normal behavior of the nodes, which is indicated on the right side by the trained SOM model. Finally, the user has now insights on the performance degradation of the service. So the CPU and memory utilization values indicate a low resources issue, indicating that by increasing the number of virtual CPUs and or RAM memory capacity, the reported latency issues could be eliminated. And that will be confirmed in our service profiling segment as well. So finally, the last part of the report, the service profiling. So, this functionality collects information regarding the execution of the tested service on different resources combinations based on the specifications provided on the blueprints and descriptors of the service. This information is used to compare the performance across the various combinations of resources, and having this comparison provides the vertical with insights on the estimated performance of the service for different deployments. In this way, the vertical has a correlation of the expected performance of the service regarding the cost of those resources, as well as the effect of a possible scaling of the service. So in this particular case, we can see how the performance difference across the different deployments indicates that the issue caused by fault injection introduced earlier can be resolved using higher resources. And in this case, scaling up the service will probably offer significant performance increase regarding the round trip time and request response latency KPIs. And on the other hand, if we are using the medium or high resources deployment as a basis for the comparison, it becomes clear that in a real-world scenario without fault injection, reducing the resources of the deployment could possibly lead to reducing costs with a minimal performance hit. This is just one of the possible insights that can be extracted from the generated information. And the possibilities vary depending on the requested KPIs, the amount of detail regarding the resources available that can be encoded in the description of the service, and as well as the type of the service itself. And I think that concludes our second demo video. Thank you.
Okay, thanks a lot to all our WINGS colleagues for this very interesting session on the platform features. Now I think it's time to collect some questions, if you have. So, any questions from the participants to our WINGS colleagues or to me and Manuel for these first three sessions? Everything crystal clear? Okay, then we can take probably a very short break just to stretch the legs because the webinar is still very long. So it's 10 to 3. We can try to save some time and take a 5 minutes break. So we can start at 5 to 3, just a very short coffee. And we will start with the session on multi-site capabilities from Spain. So meet you in 5 minutes.